only way to get to the North American Cup is to travel through the highlight zone. In Buffalo, John Tavares lights the lamp to lead the way to victory. In Philly, success is spelled G-A-I-T as Paul makes the wings fly. Two unbeaten teams battle it out in front of a rocket house in the Autumn Buffalo. Tonight on Prime Network. Network presents the Major Indoor Lacrosse League Game of the Week. From Memorial Auditorium in Buffalo, New York, it's a battle of the unbeatens as the Wings and the Bandits go at it. Hello, everyone. John Horton along with Lee Belsmo, and we're going to be talking a lot about numbers tonight. Some awesome numbers, like 406 days since the Buffalo Bandits last lost a game. But the big story here, both teams at 6-0. Leave some awesome numbers individually and team-wise for these teams.
When you look at the offensive power on both teams, it becomes incredible when you add it all up. Take a look at this. In the game tonight, the top five goal scorers, four of the top five assist leaders, eight of the top 10 point leaders. These two teams are loaded. They are carrying the league. Offensively, first and second. Defensively, first and third. It doesn't get any better when you match up talent for talent.
Individually, we have a great matchup. Two of the best scorers in the game, two of the best players in the game, John Tavares and Paul Gate.
No question about it. Here they are. These are superstars in the game of lacrosse. Paul Gate with his brother Gary, 25 goals for Paul, 12 assists, 37 points. But the best player in the game right now in the Major Indoor Lacrosse League is John Tavares. 27 goals, 20 assists, 47 points. John can do everything on the field a little bit better than anybody else. Both of those guys, superstars. The biggest game tonight might be the difference.
And just one more number to talk about, 16,325. That's how many people will be packed in the odd for tonight's game, the Battle of the Undefeated. It's the Bandits against the Wings on Prime Network. Tonight's Major Indoor Lacrosse League Game of the Week is brought to you by Coors Light. It's the right beer now. By Adidas, the official footwear supplier of Major Indoor Lacrosse. And by Brine, the power behind the game. We'll be back with the opening face-off of the Battle of the Unbeatens from the odd in Buffalo. Welcome back to the odd in Buffalo. All the seats are pretty much filled. They're standing in the rafters, ready for this one. Take a look at the series record here.
Well, of course, the one we remember was last year in the championship game. Buffalo leads the series 2-0, and that overtime victory is well on the minds of the Philadelphia Wings squad.
Taking a look at the starting goalies, Dallas Elliott, one of the best.
Quite possibly the best. This is the guy everybody measures up to if you want to see how good you're doing. 76.6 save average, leads the league. Right behind him, though, is Ross Cowie. Hasn't played as many minutes, but there's a very good save percentage of 70.9. Both of these goalies, John, you are used to seeing 43, 44 shots per game. Today, these high-powered offenses should shoot 60-plus shots.
We have a wild opening, ready for what could be a wild game. The Wings will start it off on the offense. Paul Gate getting it started.
Paul had a little trick going with Gary. He tried to wave him into the cylinder. Gary didn't go very far.
Dedekin has it taken away from him. Nice stick check there by Bill Mahar.
That's the kind of shot Cowie likes to see. He comes out so high in the box, easy for him to save that kind of shot.
What a shot by Kilgore off the bat.
And John, reminiscent of last year's championship game when the face mask was literally ripped off his face, protection by a hard shot from the outside.
Troy Cordingley slips on the carpet right in front of the crease. Darius Kilgore flips it over, shot taken by Veltman. And there won't be many stoppages in play as far as them going back and forth. This one will go all the way. Kilgore flips it up. Looks like he was just trying to advance it to himself.
Well, he's trying to get a hold of it. He couldn't quite grab it. Sheck pulls it in. This is the line with Gate and Sheck. Three tight end type bodies. Very big and strong. Got 6'2", 210, 215.
On the line change, Bates comes out along with McAvoy, Finneran, and Chris Flynn. This is John McAvoy. Tried to get it in front for Paul Denikin. Unable to do it. Bates picks it up. And a loose ball push called away from the ball. And the Bandits will have it.
John, they don't like to match up too much in the Major NLL Lacrosse League because it goes so fast. But I can tell you right now that the line with Keenan and Beltman for Buffalo will try to match up with the Gate line. You'll see them on the floor to play the tough defense. Beltman and Keenan on the Gates.
Alexander and Volker going after the 50-50 ball picked up by Stu Ayer. In front, Burnham. Randy Marnes tried to flip it in front. Gets his own loose ball. Takes the shot from the outside just as the 30-second clock expires.
I think as a general observation, we've watched Buffalo a lot this season. They usually start off slow. They're usually pretty lethargic. Not lethargic, just they have an even tempo through the first quarter. Many times find themselves behind in the first quarter. I think they sense the importance of this game against an undefeated team, a two-time world champion. They look like they've stepped it up a little bit here in the first quarter.
We played just over 2 minutes so far with no score. Here's McAvoy. Finneran played off the ball on the cross check there by Mark Burnham. And Dallas Elliott has to pick up the loose ball.
This is the second line for the wings. Flynn, Finneran, McAvoy, Bates, and Tony Resch on the defense. And then on the offense, it might be Paul Denikin.
Ball intercepted. And the Bandits will have it. But some of the comparisons in this game between the two teams.
Well, both teams play one goal better at home than they do away from their home arena. So that makes this game about a three-goal difference if you just go by the averages. Buffalo will be 3 goals better.
Rich Kilgore fires one to Elliott, who parries it over the bar. And the Bandits will retain possession in the offensive end.
No surprise, Dallas Elliott starting in the goal for the Wings, but a little bit of a decision had to be made to get Ross Cowley in there. He really hasn't started only one game. Is the only start he had this year. Usually comes off the bench, but his numbers are decidedly better than Bill Gary's.
Brian Hall with a shot. Elliott with a stick save. What a shot by Hamley on Volker. Another shot by the big man Glenn Lay in the corner, and they're going at it at the odd.
Glenn Lay came in there to enforce it on the boards, and then he got a little help from his buddy Bob Hamley. But watch Glenn Lay's offhand. It's the offhand that really gets him in trouble. The shot will come in. He goes to the boards. There he goes. After this hit, it goes against the boards, and Lay comes in, and that's where he gets in trouble using that offhand against the boards. He got caught for that. Hamley comes in just to enforce things as a backup.
And a 2-minute penalty called against Bob Hamley. So the Wings on the very dangerous power play. The Gate brothers out there along with Kevin Finneran, Rob Sheck, and Paul Denikin. This is Paul Gate. Sheck. Denikin back to Rob Sheck. Paul Gate at the point. Fires deflected wide by Cowie. And look at Cowie going over the top, making sure that nobody gets the ball.
Nice job by Cowie. He comes out high in the box to take away the shot by Gate.
Counterattack, Tavares in front, played off the ball by Gary Gate. Going the other way, Rob Sheck. Two on two, Sheck powered over by Ayer. But Ayer broke up the play, that's what's important. Bandits have an opportunity the other way. Darius Kilgore keeps it despite the defense, sends the shot in. Elliott with the save.
Two great saves by Elliott, and the pressure is intense. The fast break came down. Both teams showing great foot speed.
Accordingly to the back of the net.
Accordingly, it was right in the cylinder. It's where you want to be. The defense didn't knock him out, and he had a chance to turn and take the shot. Watch that. Right in the cylinder, you've got to take his body out of there, and right in front of Elliott, he has the full 18 feet to shoot at. pulls it in. The defense sleeping a little bit. Gabe Curling a chance to turn around and spot a target. The rookie gets the first goal of the game.
Troy Cordingley, the rookie, with his seventh goal this season, and after an illegal procedure call, the Bandits get it right back. And look at the shot from way outside! How about that? Tavares! We're going to have to take another look at this one because it looked like Tavares put it in, and he did! My oh my!
Absolutely, Tavares gets that credit for that goal, but obviously, Dallas Elliott was looking for Cordingley to get it in the cylinder again. Very opportunistic goal because the goalie Elliott had just gotten stung by Cordingley. Cordingley was coming in the cylinder, hoping or afraid that he would catch that ball and stick it in his face again. His attention was on Cordingley. Cordingley misses the ball. It goes under his stick.
Talk about the importance of two shorthanded goals.
I think in this game, an early lead is very critical, especially for Philadelphia. Not quite as explosive as Buffalo, but you know that they didn't probably expect to have the early lead here at the home. They've got to stay within three before they get really nervous.
John Conley takes the shot. Hamley on the loose ball, and here come the Bandits.
You know, John, one thing we didn't talk about was the man-down unit. Two short-handed goals. They put Tavares, Les Bartley did, but they put Tavares on that man-down unit for the first time as a regular and paid dividends already in the first quarter.
Darris Kilgore tried to get it in front for Glenn Lay. Rob Hoynes picks up the ball but pays for it. We're going to take a break, be back with more. 2-0 Bandits on Drive Network. The Wings have the ball as we return. John Nostrandt looking for the shot. Cowie deflects it wide. Two shorthanded goals early have been the difference in this one. Ross Cowie picking up the loose ball.
You know, John, last year this configuration, of course, wasn't in place. The Gates were in Detroit. But when Buffalo played the Gates in Detroit, they pretty much stopped them cold late in the season. They've got two great defensive players in Beltman and Keenan that put the handcuffs on them. Tonight, that could be the biggest factor in the game.
Derek Keenan tried to use the screen, gets the ball back, intercepted Mark Hahn for the Wings. Hahn had a release man in Paul Gate, but didn't see him. Here's Gary Gate. Gary Gate in front. Save Cowie. Jim Beltman picking up the long ball. Plays it cross court to Alexander. Deflected wide, Elliott. Beltman. In the corner to Tavares. Tavares winds up, but has it knocked out on the stick check by Tony Resch. Beltman on the loose ball. We call him Dr. Hoover.
He can really suck up the ground balls, but Beltman is a great scorer in the leagues up in Canada. He can definitely put the ball in the net. He's only missed the goal once out of his 12 shots this year.
Tavares tries to get the shot off as he's pushed down, and that'll be a two-minute penalty call against Tony Resch and the fans here at the Odd-Lincoln.
These two teams have great winning streaks, but there's a little bit of something else going on. Look at the last six games. They've won 14 in a row, rather, dating back to February 8th, including three playoff victories. This is the longest streak for the Bandits in the history of the league. But look at what's happening here. In this year, the first three games, Buffalo wins by margins of 7. The last three games, 1-2. They've gone down 5. Philadelphia, meanwhile, used to win by margins of 4. Now, in the last three games, they're winning by margins of 8. That is up significantly. Two teams possibly going in opposite directions.
But the Bandits not playing like that. They're playing very well early. We've played 8 minutes in this one. Up 2-0. Shot by Hamley. Elliott with a save.
Well, John, we noticed Buffalo getting a little bit complacent. I'll hold that thought.
Finneran on the breakaway. Save Cowie. Paul Gate misses the ball. Finneran goes after it. It's loose at midfield. And Finneran will pick it up. Your thought?
Well, my thought was we've seen this team play, Buffalo, maybe a little bit lethargically. Once you win 10, 13, 11, 12, 13 in a row, you start losing a little bit of your drive. Tonight, they are focused and ready to prove themselves.
Hamlin, Darris Kilgore parried over the bar by Elliott. Tavares has trouble holding it. Gabrielson picks it up, looks long for Finneran. Finneran is there, one on none. Cowie with a save. That's like a penalty shot.
Cowie does a great job. Look at him. Ross comes out. Big target, Ross, as he comes out very high in the crease to take away the shooting angle.
Darius Kilgore fires, hits the pipe. Flynn off the long rebound, counterattack wings, two-on-two situation. Flynn fires and Cowie comes out, saves it, Flynn tries it again, that one hits the pipe.
John, you see the angle that he cuts down? When Cowie comes out that high, it really takes away most of your shot. You've got to make at least one pass. It's an easy shot for another player. Make one pass, you'll beat Cowie.
Three-on-two, four-on-two as Keenan tries it. Kilgore misses the loose ball. That could be dangerous. John McAvoy on the counterattack. Save Cowie. McAvoy picks it back up. He'll try it again. Cowie with another save. Both teams at equal strength. Alexander has his helmet knocked off him right in front by Gary Martin. And they're going to call Martin for a two-minute penalty.
This is one of the greatest players to ever play the game. And either the United States or Canada, he gets leveled by one of the defensive specialists, Martin. Helmet comes off, 37 years old. Look at this man. He is in the Hall of Fame in Canada and one of the leading offensive players here in the NLL. Still down. The knees aren't what they used to be, but the stick skills are excellent. Watch the shot from outside, hit the post. Goalie's best friend. And then the other end, the action just as hot. Watch as we come down and hit this pipe. This is the shot by McAvoy, I believe, where look at this distance right there behind the goal. You can see all the space behind Ross Cowie. He's way out in front. All that distance gives a great target for Philly, but they've got to make one pass. If you try to shoot against that target by coming out very high, he fills up the goal.
Two players whistled for a penalty. Gary Martin and Tony Resch. It is 5-on-3. Darius Kilgore tries the first shot. Finneran picks it up, and that's very important. The Wings have to kill the penalty.
Nobody, neither of these coaches want to get into a big man down deal. They don't want to get hurt by being in the box.
Buffalo, number two in the league in most penalties, 66 penalties for 153 minutes, while Philadelphia is fourth with 42 for 113 minutes.
And as I mentioned, John, neither coach wants to get into a disadvantage. They want to keep the players out of the box.
Derek Keenan right in front, can't get it by Dallas Elliott. Here's Gary Gate, joined by Finneran. It's two on two, Gary Gate hits the pipe. And pays for the shot. Counterattack. Derek Keenan fires, hits the post again.
Did a nice job of faking as if he was going to go to the wing to Tavares, but Dallas Elliott stood his ground.
Gate and Paul forgot the ball. Counterattack, here we go, Tavares. Stu Aird. But Dallas Elliott pulls it in.
Well, Aird couldn't handle the last pass. Tavares gave it up one too many times. He had a shot, didn't take it.
Paul Gate puts the Wings on the board.
That's why he's a great one.
A double shorthanded goal. That's one that you don't see many times.
Watch Paul go through the defensive push of the Bandits, and when he comes inside, he goes to the far pipe. Hamley pushes him out. He'll lean in with that left hand and just put it inside the far pipe.
2-1 here at the Autumn Buffalo. The Bandits with a lead.
Drum roll, please. Here are the top 10 reasons to watch Prime. Number 10, it's a really cheap date. Number 9, good digestive viewing fortified with vitamins and minerals. Number 8, every night is ladies' night. Number 7, good wholesome programming for the whole family to enjoy. Number 6, male bonding. Number 5, car cams, net cams, slam cams. Number 4, sorry, we're out of time. Okay, number 3, number 2, and number 1. Because everyone loves a winner.
Buffalo, 2-1. The Bandits with the lead. All three goals scored tonight have been shorthanded goals.
It shows you the speed that they're exhibiting out there. As soon as they get some open area, they're taking off on both ends of the field and getting those one-on-ones with Cowie and Elliott.
Bandits on the super power play for 16 seconds. But maybe not get another opportunity to shoot it. Five on the super power play, and now both teams will be at full strength. Gary Gate with a shot. John Tavares will allow the line to change. Troy Cordingley, the first out there, joined by Randy Marnes and Stu Aird. Kevin Alexander will go out there, and looks like a little bit of confusion on the Bandits bench. Here's Alexander with three on the shot clock, and that'll be a 30-second violation, so the Wings will take over. Take a look at the leading scores, full of Wings and Bandits.
Tavares leads everybody, 7.8 point average. Paul Gate, Garrigate right behind. Rob Schett, all three of those Wings right there. Veltman's statistics a little bit deceiving because he missed two games. He'd be right up in the pack if he had those two offensive efforts.
The rookie Troy Cordingley working against McAvoy. McAvoy pushes him down, and for the second time, Cordingley having trouble with footing. Here's Chris Bates on the counterattack. Tom Amick is there to slow him down. Kevin Finneran, what a talented player he is. Finneran with a shot right into the chest pad of Cowie, and you'll see how Cowie's looking for that long ball.
Well, you also see how he's filling up. Again, I keep talking about him coming out high in the cylinder, high in the box there, and you can't really come in, let him track you, and then take one shot. You need to make a feed to another player, and that's really going to hurt Ross Cowie. If they start moving the ball on Philadelphia's team, they'll hurt Cowie with that high stance in the box.
Kilgore couldn't find an angle, trying to get it to the big man Glenn Lay right in front. He'll try again. Lay with a shot. The sliding save by Dallas Elliott. 90 seconds to go in the quarter.
And I don't think we've ever seen a faster paced first quarter in this league. That was something special.
John Conway, they set up the offense. Tried to send it in front. Kilgore comes up with a ball. Has to go against two players. Plays it back to his goalie, Ross Cowie. And we're into the final minute of quarter number one with a 2-1 Bandit lead.
And the amazing point, as you mentioned, John, all the goals, man down. It's amazing with all the offense they've shown. It shows you how the top level of play is coming out of these goalies. They're making tremendous saves.
Nine on the shot clock. Keenan looking in front. Fires it to the back of the net.
Keenan does a great job of creating space with Elliott. Now watch as he comes in. He'll start moving around into the cylinder. He'll come out in this area and create space between the goalie and the inside pipe. And then the shot comes in behind and goes up in there. And that's what gave him the spot to shoot at. That movement into the cylinder. And then he finds a little bit of target on the inside pipe. Very well done by Keenan.
3-1, the Bandits. Wings looking for a final opportunity in the quarter, but it's taken away from them by Dr. Hoover and Jim Veltman. Time running down as Keenan sets up in front to Dennis Kilgore behind the back. Hits the pipe. 10 to go as Mahar takes it. Passes blocked. Conley picks it up with 5 seconds. Veltman will take a shot. Cordingley will watch the clock run down. I think Cordingley thought he had a little bit more time. We are out of time in quarter number one. We've got three quarters to go. 3-1. The Bandits have the lead in front of a great sounding crowd in Buffalo. Ooh, that one was close. Back at the odd end, Buffalo Bandits lead it 4-1 here in the first half.
And John, this is that second line that's so tough for Buffalo with Keenan and Veltman. Accordingly now off the field with the injury, Miles General, number 6, will step in his place. He's running on this line right now.
Omahar works it in the corner with 9 on the shot clock. Shot intercepted by Martin Volker on the counterattack.
Volker, a defensive player from Johns Hopkins. You see him come off the field right now. They'll get an offensive player on for him.
No strength to Conley to the back of the net. What a shot by John Conley.
Tremendous shot by JC. One of the leaders of the Philadelphia Wings, and he just cannon shot. Takes it maybe from way outside. And normally this is the kind that Cowie will absolutely eat up. But he shoots from way out here and goes way up into the corner. And that's what beats Cowie. Normally, right there, look at that. That is blocking that by coming way out. That distance there is all blocked because of his distance away from the goal.
John Conley, one of the grand old men of the Major Indoor Lacrosse League.
He was in tremendous shape. Conley, as strong as they come. And really, I think it's gotten better offensively as the years have gone on.
So, a 2-goal game now. Scott Gabrielson trying to make it a 1-goal game. His shot goes wide.
But John, you know, Philadelphia, in my estimation, really hasn't done what they have to do to beat Cowie. Cowie has been very strong, and again, it's that same old technique of coming up high. If you're going to beat him, you've got to move the ball and get to the back side of him.
Now, as good as Ross Cowie is playing, does Les Bartley go with him in the second half?
I think he goes as long as he's playing well. He'll go the whole game if things are going well, unless he gets a big lead, and nobody would anticipate that happening. Then he might get a break.
Counterattack Wings, Paul Gate. Taken down, gets the shot away. And we're going to see a penalty. Let's talk a little bit about the goalies. There you see Ross Cowie.
Now here are the goalies as they stack up. 78% for Elliott, 71% for Cowie. And Gary, who has started almost every game, to 66%. But look at the shots. They're used to taking 40 shots. Gary only 32 shots per game. In this game, because of the high-powered offenses, the goalies that are playing will see 60-plus shots. That is a lot, and you're not used to it on a game-to-game basis.
Those percentages being save percentages there.
Save percentages, and a normal game again, they'll see 43 shots. We saw those graphics. So 60 shots, you can increase that by 50%. Very, very difficult for a goalie to go 4 quarters at that kind of pace, taking that many shots.
Tom Emick whistled for the penalty, taking down Paul Gate. Power play opportunity for the Philadelphia Wings. This is Paul Gate at the point. Behind the back to Rob Sheck. Sheck off the shoulder pad of Cowie. They reload. Paul Gate fires over the top. Possession will go to Buffalo.
Both shots again. I don't want to sound like the coach, but if you're watching, Cowie is giving you the shots behind him. You've got to make one pass to get a tough shot. Gary and Paul Gate have scored 42% of a Philly goal. I talked about the importance of these two players. Just imagine if you can neutralize those two guys, how devastating that will be to the Philadelphia offense.
To make the analogy in the pro basketball, if you neutralize a Michael Jordan like that, you do have your Scottie Pippins in the background, but still.
So let's say you neutralize Pippen and Jordan. Then you're in deep trouble, and that's about what it amounts to. I think Buffalo's bench, everybody would agree, a little bit deeper, they can go to the third and fourth man and get a big game from him.
Under 7 minutes to go in the first half. 4-2 Bandits. Veltman over to the far side of the wing. Alexander. Here's Veltman at the right point.
4 seconds on the shot clock.
And Veltman won't be able to get the shot away as the horn goes right as he shoots it. And the officials are saying it was a 30-second violation. No, they're saying reset the clock, give it back to the Bandits.
Well, Veltman had it timed pretty beautifully. He knew exactly where it was. He had a good eyeball on that clock. Took it just in time, and he wasn't going to give up that advantage. He argued with the refs, got the ball back. He didn't even ever give the ball up. Matter of fact, he just held on to it and said, wait.
And quite frankly, these are the smallest shot clocks in the league. Very difficult to read. I don't know how the players can read them down there. 51 seconds to go in the penalty. To Tom Emick. Alexander in front, going for the shorthanded goal. Tavares almost got it by Elliott. Well, but Gary that resets Gate, the shot clock.
And John, Gary Gate went down there to double Alexander and left Tavares open. Tavares came in behind the slide of Gary Gate, was wide open, couldn't get the shot off.
Tavares hits the top pipe. Veltman picks up the loose ball. 20 on the shorthanded situation, and Buffalo has been masterful at killing the penalty.
I was looking at Veltman's stick before the game. Veltman's got a great soft pocket. He's got a soft, deep mesh pocket with thin walls on his stick. He chooses that to give him great skill in picking up loose balls. It's very forgiving in a loose ball situation. What he loses is an accurate, hard shot, a shot that could be a little harder. It could be a little more accurate with a skinnier stick with a string lacing. It would have the ball coming out of there faster. But he's got the great stats as a ground ball man. He knows his role.
And the Wings would like to talk about it before the faceoff. 5:43 to go in the first half. It's an exciting one.
Give me the
all in Buffalo.
No matter what your abilities are, no matter what your age.
4-2 the score. It seems like there's a lot more. But watch this move by Tavares. He went down behind the defense of Gate. Comes off the pipe. The sixth pipe shot possibly we've seen. This feed behind the back again gives you a shot of Tavares taking yet another shot. Saved by Elliott. Elliott very active. And John, the goalies could be a key factor. We know Geary can play, has a lot of minutes behind Cowie. If Elliott gets tired, and they've got to go to Andy Piazza. Andy Piazza was a first-team All-American in North Carolina, tremendous goalie in the field game, but he hasn't had many minutes in this game against this competition. That would be a tough thing for Philly to do.
Duncan's shot is blocked out front by Duncan. Tom Emick for the Bandits. Emick has a wide-open shot deflected wide by Elliott. With a shot of Elliott, just moves the net. And that's going to be a two-minute penalty. Called against Elliott, and now we will get to see Andy Piazza.
Piazza's strapping on the leather. He's going to have to come into this game. Elliott just yanked that goal off. He was in trouble. Not a smart move, because nowadays, if you do that purposely, look at this. He comes up, it's a sensational save. Now, that was okay, because he hit it. Watch him now. He'll grab it, yank it behind the crease area. That cost him 2 minutes. Bad move by Dallas, because this puts his team in a bad spot. He didn't have to do this. One save there. Watch this fantastic save. That's okay. His body hit the goal. They would have reset and given time. But he got up and pushed it out of the crease area just to save himself what he thought was an embarrassing moment. He had done his job.
Thinking back to that halftime piece, I wonder what the angle would be on that shot.
It was goofy. There we go.
Was to the back of the net, 5-2.
Now you can't fault Andy Piazza. No warm-up, absolutely none. Watch him come in with a bounce shot. Not a hard shot, but just very accurately placed. It'll come off to the side. It's going to come onto this wing and get the shot from Hamley, who comes inside. Beautifully done. Now he'll come in. He's going to bounce it and take it right up inside there. And just a tough job for Andy Piazza with no warm-ups. Now we'll see it from a little bit behind Piazza. He comes out, sets himself, did not get comfortable. How can you be comfortable? You come into the game with no warm-up at all.
Rich Kilgore tries to test Dallas Elliott as he welcomes him back. And look at Ross Cowie coming out of the net. Ball was nailed by Rob Hoynes, and they're going to whistle Hoynes for a two-minute penalty. As Brian Hall may be seeing some stars. Look at the way it knocked that helmet.
Well, Philadelphia definitely becoming the enforcers here, but this is not something that Dave Evans wants to see. That offense, a power play, is tremendous for Buffalo. You don't want to put your team into a man-down situation. Great hit, but a little bit high. Again, Cowie comes over, gives him the pass, turns into a buddy pass. The check is okay, except this check came high. You can see the stick come up for Rob Hoynes above the shoulders into the face area. That's what gave him the 2 minutes in the box.
And Hoynes went over to Brian Hall, and it looked like they might have some words. Instead, he went over and said, sorry, came up a little bit high, but they're going to call him for a 5-minute major for roughing.
Well, in the last 2 minutes, Hoynes is fouled and Elliott's fouled. Could have taken them out of the game. If they can get two or three goals in this major, Philadelphia's in trouble.
If you're not familiar with the rules concerning major penalties in the Major Indoor Lacrosse League, two goals will release a major penalty, unlike in hockey where you can shoot all the time for 5 minutes.
Let's take a look at some of the common opponents by these two teams. They've each played Baltimore, Detroit, and Boston. They played Boston even. They played Detroit even, too, because Philly played them at home. They got a three-goal advantage for that, and Buffalo played them away, so they did well there. Baltimore was the big difference. Philly beat them by 14 goals. Buffalo beat them in overtime by one. This is part of that trend where we think the league is catching up to Buffalo. Meanwhile, Philadelphia playing together with the Gates is on a little bit more of a roll until this game.
Kevin Alexander, the hero last time in Baltimore with the overtime goal to give them the 19-18 win. And there's Dallas Elliott from Vancouver, British Columbia. And we will be across the border from Canada next week when we go to Detroit. The Saints take on the Turbos in what could be quite a defensive battle if last week's game was any indication.
Two second-place teams. They're looking to position themselves beautifully for the playoffs. The Turbos really think they have a shot at Buffalo. New York, of course, they lost twice to the Wings in the last 2 weeks. They want to get their offense back on track looking forward to the playoffs.
Major power play as Hamley tries the first shot.
Beautifully done, though, when you can move the ball like that. That's the kind of passing that Philadelphia used that against Cowie. They're going to have a huge target. You play so beautifully at the top of the crease, you move the ball to two or three people, you're going to have a tremendous target behind them.
3:50 to go on the game clock, 4:35 on the penalty clock, so chances are the Wings will be playing shorthanded for the rest of the half. This is John Conley on the shorthanded unit, flips it back to Rob Scheck. Scheck spins, fires, and that one goes wide as the 30-second shot clock expires.
And Tavares did a nice job of noticing where the shot clock was and going all the way downfield, and that's where he is to pick up that pass.
There's your marquee matchup, Tavares going one-on-one against Paul Gate.
And Tavares on the defensive end of the field, all the way to your left. As soon as he made that one swinging check, he saw the shot clock go to 30 and just took off downfield. Darius Kilgore playing defense there against Gary, and that's a good sign. He had that slight injury moments about 5 minutes ago.
Rob Scheck, Paul Gate, Gary Gate in the corner. Gary Gate with a 9-iron shot. It won't go anywhere.
The only offensive player to get a Coors Light MVP in that 6-0 string other than Paul Gate was Rob Scheck.
Scheck exploded in a game against Baltimore, that 23-9 shellacking. 5-2, the Bandits with the lead and have a major penalty that they've got the power play on, but the Wings doing a masterful job killing it.
Put some nice pressure on. It's only 2 minutes into that major, and they're putting more offensive pressure on Buffalo than Buffalo is on Dallas Elliott. Elliott had that big save early in this series.
First three goals of the game were shorthanded. There's Kilgore with the shot that rocked Elliott. Keenan all alone. Elliott standing strong. Tavares pushed into the crease, rolls out. Is not a part of the offense, so no crease violation call there. There's Kilgore trying to get him by Elliott, but Elliott able to parry it. Here's Finneran, 3-on-2. Paul Gate can't catch up with the ball, picked up by Bob Hamley. Counterattack. Here's Tavares and Alexander. Alexander, Tavares, Alexander, back to Stewart. Deflected wide by Elliott.
They had it set up great, 3-on-1, ended up shooting right in front of Elliott. What a tremendous save he made. If they go pipe to pipe, Elliott can't make that save, but two of the best ball handlers in the business.
And here we go again, Alexander. Save Elliott Hamley on the rebound. Errant shot, Tavares goes after it, gets it over to Alexander. Alexander rocked into the boards by Chris Flynn. And we're into the last minute. Flynn to Martin, deflected wide by Cal Wee, as they say here in Buffalo.
Feldman
looking long, almost scored it from the backcourt.
Yes. Wow. That's a tremendous sight for him to see that Elliott was well out of the goal. Here comes Paul Gate.
Paul Gate looking to give some momentum to the wings. But the momentum has stopped there, and here we go again the other way. Alexander at midfield, 21 to go in the half.
Trying to get a timeout. Buffalo could not get one. They didn't hold the ball long enough. 14 seconds left.
Coors Light halftime report coming up. And a whistle and a penalty will be called.
Looks like Stu Aird's going to get, no, Veltman, huh? Number 32, Jim Veltman's going to get the call.
Has this been the roughest game we've seen all year?
Very physical, a lot of pride at stake here. You know, the fact is that probably doesn't matter much the standings of these two great undefeated teams as far as the playoffs are concerned, but each of these teams wants to prove to the other they are the best. Coming in 6-0, you don't have to fire them up at all. These two teams are fired up on their own. Watch the hit. Veltman coming in 32, goes high. Actually didn't make any contact at all. Veltman gets hurt by hitting his own man. That was Brian Hall coming in.
So 8 seconds to go, and the Wings looking to get the last second shot. Gary Gate puts it into Cowie, who loses it in his path, but that kills the rest of the clock in the half, and the fans here in Buffalo very appreciative of their Bandits. When we return, the Coors Light halftime report. Lee Felsmo talks to the general manager of the most successful team in the Major Indoor Lacrosse League. That's when we return on the Coors Light halftime report. 5-2 Bandits on Prime Network.
When traveling, stay where the teams of the Major Indoor Lacrosse League stay. In Baltimore, the Sheraton Inner Harbor. In Boston, the 57 Park Plaza Hotel. In Buffalo, the Buffalo Hilton. In Detroit, the Omni International. In New York, the Long Island Marriott. In Philadelphia, the Philadelphia Airport Marriott. Stay at the best, the official hotels of the Major Indoor Lacrosse League.
Lacrosse is America's fastest growing and most exciting sport. And for the best in equipment, it's Allman Sports International. Sticks with exclusive Allman pockets. Custom dyed with your team colors. Helmets, gloves, and protective gear. Team jerseys, shorts, sweats, t-shirts, and other great accessories. Allman Sports International has everything you need to play your best and look great doing it. For a free catalog, call 1-800-BESTICK.
Welcome back to the auditorium in Buffalo, and welcome to our Coors Light halftime report. Hi, everybody, I'm Lee Felsmo, and it's my pleasure to introduce you to the most successful general manager currently in the MILL, John Meridian of the Buffalo Bandits. John, it is going good.
Yeah, we're really excited about tonight's game and what's happened this past season. We're 6-0, and Philly's 6-0, and we're going to go head-to-head tonight to see who's going to be the winner.
All right, talk about the general success of your team. Every time you go out there, you're setting records all over the offensive end of the floor. 14 straight wins coming into tonight. The success is really unparalleled in the league.
Well, when we started with the Bandits, we really felt that to be successful in this league, you have to be scoring 19 and 20 goals a game. We were looking at what had happened in the previous 5 years, and some of the teams that were winning championships were scoring 15, 16, 14 goals. So our objective was to get a very offensively orientated team. And with that in mind, we could teach the offensive players how to play defense in the mill.
Well, one thing maybe you didn't count on was the tremendous fan support. You get it like nobody else in the league. Philadelphia is a tremendous success story, but nobody does better than the odd for fan support.
Well, Buffalo's a great sports town. The hockey draws very well. The Bills draw extremely well. And even with the new Blizzard soccer, people are starting to come to the odd. And we're really fortunate that people in Buffalo, not knowing a lot about lacrosse, have came and saw our great product and the product in the league and have jumped on the Buffalo Bandit bandwagon.
Well, John, another thing that makes your team unique is the Native American influence. You have a lot of players from Native American teams that are great players in Canada, in northern United States. Talk about those players, if you would.
Well, we have 9 Native Americans on our team, Leaf, coming from 4 different reservations, 3 here in the United States and 1 up in Canada. And what they do for the Bandits is bring that that historical heritage touch to the odd, and with them on the turf, you know, we get a lot of support from the Native American community in upstate New York and southern Ontario.
So another reason that makes this team, that this team is absolutely unique. Your success, again, unparalleled. We wish you continued success as we move on toward the end of this year in the Major Indoor Lacrosse League. We're going to be back with more of our Coors Light Halftime Report in just a moment, so stay with us.
The action never stops with lacrosse. Matching strength and skill in an all-out battle between strategy, power, and precision. The Major Indoor Lacrosse League. It's a hit. Your home for the MILL is Prime Network. This isn't a race. It's an adventure. Travel the globe to exotic ports of call to see the true test of sailing skill for helmsmen and crew. The Omega World Grand Prix of Match Race Sailing on Prime.
Back on the Coors Light Halftime Report from the odd in Buffalo. The Bandits with a 5-2 lead over the Philadelphia Wings. John Horton and Leif Elsmo back along with you. And boy, we're only halfway finished.
Woo. It's a great win. It's everything we thought would be as far as tempo. The score is a little lower than we thought. A lot of offense, but the great goaltending is really keeping the score down to where under our expectations.
The first 3 goals of the game, all shorthanded. Let's take a look at one of them right here.
Well, the one we're going to watch here is Tavares' first goal of the game. It makes the score 2-0. Johnny Tavares, number 11, actually is kind of a fluke goal. He'll try to feed Cordingley. Cordingley can't pick it up. The defense just deflects a little bit. Elliott misses the read on it, and that made the game 2-0. Cordingley had scored the first goal. That was the second goal. Paul Gate scored, then Keenan scored. The game was 3-1 before Keenan comes in, bowls his way into the cylinder, gets his second straight goal. It's now 4-2. Then John Conley, way out in front. Watch him take this cannon shot. The veteran just rips it into the corner. Beautiful job. Look how far Cowie is. Great illustration of how far he comes out. The half ended. It was 5-2. Buffalo, 2 shorthanded goals. Philadelphia, 1 shorthanded. Keenan leads everybody with 2 goals and 1 assist.
We've still got a half to go from the odd in Buffalo. 5-2 the score. Back with a second half faceoff in just a moment. Back at the Audit Buffalo, taking a look at the first half numbers.
And the thing that really jumps out, Buffalo, 40-26 shots on goal. Penalties about even, faceoffs. Philadelphia winning that, but the shots on goal, the biggest offset in drama there. Many more, almost twice as many taken by the Buffalo team. And of course, more than twice on the scoreboard, 5-2.
Second half faceoff, and we are underway. One thing we haven't mentioned tonight, these are the 2 best faceoff teams in the league.
Well, Philadelphia getting the better of it tonight. Alexander is really a veteran who can dominate that kind of pressure situation in the faceoff area. But tonight, Philadelphia is doing a good job leading in that category.
As we return, it's a 4-on-4 situation. The Wings with 20 seconds to go on a penalty. Bandits with 1:23 to go in the penalty to Jim Beltman that was called just before the half ended.
Cowie and Elliott back in the goal.
Stu Air to the back of the net. That took about 40 seconds.
Well, the defense wasn't set at all, and Elliott was really kind of shaken. He'll come down, and just nobody picks up this drive. He'll come all the way around. Elliott looking for some help. As he comes around, he's going to find himself right back in on the cylinder. Elliott standing up, not quite sure which way to guess. He normally guesses one way and gives you the other. It was a shot right inside there that gave him the goal. Air doing it all on his own with nobody backing up to keep him out of the cylinder.
Stu Air out of the University of Windsor, Oakdale, Ontario. A lot of fans make the trek across the border from Ontario to watch Major Indoor Lacrosse League action, both here at the Odd and at the JLA in Detroit. Drop Check with a shot to the back of the net, makes it 6-3, and quietly the Wings look to get back into it.
Well, nice job by Sheck. Sheck is going to create some space in that hole I talk about. Again, you're going to see Cowie come up very high. He's up here very high, and the ball comes in behind him and up in that area. Cowie giving it too much space between the pipes and his position. Sheck set himself a little bit lower that time to give him a little bit of an angle for that behind-the-goalie shot.
And Rob Sheck is able to explode, much like the Gate brothers, and can be a very dangerous force.
Let me tell you, if you had a bag over their head and had them standing in a shadow, you wouldn't know the difference. They're all built the same, 6'2", 215, very strong, very fast, and excellent stick skills.
Derek Keenan and Brian Hall in a 2-on-4 situation, so the Bandits will hold it up, wait for some reinforcements. As we're back to both teams playing at full strength, Hamley with a shot, Elliott with a save. 6-3 Bandits here in the third quarter. Glenn Lay, the big man, Hall, right to the back of the net.
The Bandits really take advantage of a defense that's putting pressure on the ball. When you come all the way across and you come back in, that's what makes the goalie move pipe to pipe. Very difficult to make that transition from the left pipe to the right pipe. That's 4.5 feet, and you can see how sprawling and uncomfortable Elliott looks. That's the kind of passing that Philadelphia has to do against this man, Ross Cowie.
Ross Cowie with a big save, and after every big save, 16,325 say Cowie. Brian Hall wants to make it 2 goals in a row, but Elliott able to get the stick in that. Rob Sheck taken down by Hamley, but Sheck will play it back to Dallas Elliott. Gate tries it, Emick pulls it away, and Emick just tosses it down towards the bench. And it actually goes out the door. So the Wings will get possession. They have the line of the two Gate brothers, Rob Sheck, Scott Gabrielson, and Paul Denikin out there for the offense. Paul Gate spins, fires, hits the post, and it bounces all the way back to midfield.
We've got 10 total goals, 9 different players scoring those 10 goals. You only got to repeat Keenan.
Rob Sheck trying to repeat, and Cowie has to pull it out of the pads.
John, I'm starting to sound redundant, but again, that's the Sheck's got a great shot from outside, don't get me wrong, but when Cowie, with his style, comes out high, fills up 4 by 4.5, you've really got to make one feed. They need more activity off the ball to really take advantage of Cowie's style.
Speeds in front for Tavares. Taken over top by the elbow of Elliott.
And I can tell you, Elliott's sensational play has got Tavares thinking too much. He's thinking 1 or 2 fakes more than he normally does because of the sensational play of Dallas Elliott. He's got to let his instincts take over. He's a plenty good shooter. He should know that. But that's what a great goalie will do to you. He makes you think too much. You always think this isn't a good enough shot to beat this guy.
Kevin Finneran over to Denikin. This is Finneran playing the give and go, and Denikin almost got it by Cowie. Flynn fires it, but Cowie, early release. Here comes Tavares, and here come the Bandits. Tavares, Stewart can't hold on to it. Picks up the loose ball. Looking to create the play, Tavares on the one touch. Elliott there.
Well, they got it through beautifully. 2 defenders there, but they still got that snake feed right through and challenged Elliott with little or no angle.
7-3, the Bandits lead it. 7-4, as Kevin Finneran makes it a 3-goal game with 9:48 to go in period number 3.
Finneran just sees a little bit of white there, and he'll just take that shot left-handed up into the far corner. The goalie's left. Bingo, right up in there. And that gives him the 4th goal for the Wings.
7-4, Bandits lead it at the odd. Back in a moment. It's the game of the week. Major Indoor Lacrosse League on Prime Network. 7-4, the Bandits with the lead. 9:48 to go, third quarter, and on the faceoff, Keenan against Conley. Fight for the ball, nobody has it yet.
John, we watch teams struggle this year. Very often, they don't get two goals in a row. They get the one goal, the other team gets a couple, they get one, the other team gets a couple. That's what's happening tonight. Paul Gate, Conley, Shet, and Finneran, all single goals. The last time we saw the Philadelphia squad really go on a tear against Boston on our prime game of the week, Paul Gate had 6 of the last 9 goals. They need somebody to step forward, and usually it's one of the Gate brothers.
Rob Hoynes with a shot there, tries to get his own rebound, Mark Hahn. Has it taken away by Darius Kilgore, looking for the counterattack. Kilgore has a break. He puts on the extra effort, playing against Conley. Kilgore sends the shot too high. Bill Maher there for the rebound. Maher looking for the centering pass, has Dunkman there if he wants it. Plays it off the board to Brian Hall. Ball is loose in front of the crease. Elliott gets out of the crease, but none of the Bandits can get to the ball. Nice sweeping motion there by Gary Martin as he goes against Keenan for the ball, but Dr. Hoover, Jim Dunkman, able to pick it up and send a shot before the 30-second clock.
Almost got it, but not quite. They're going back to play defense.
Don't forget to need a car. Just call 3-3.
One thing that does not look good for Philadelphia, if you're rooting for them to win this one, is that all four of these goals, if you think back as I look at that score sheet, unassisted, basically. Basically unassisted. Again, you're going to beat Cowie, and basically, as a rule, you've got to move that ball on offense. They need more action off the ball.
Paul Gate behind the back to Garrett Gate, but that shot goes wide. No reset of the shot clock. It'll be a reset there after the Gabrielson shot. Rob Sheck dives in, but Cowie is there being extra tough. Maybe a little bit too tough. He's got to watch out. They didn't call 2 minutes off.
He was getting a little too tough in there. Sheck, tough player from Towson State, first team All-American in the midfield position. He's going to come in and just launch himself across the crease. Watch him coming right inside the defense and then underneath the Cowie. Cowie says, hey, this is my turf, buddy. And really, that could have got him a penalty. Sheck, to his credit, did not retaliate. Got up, walked away.
I say, let's make some noise out there.
Mark Burnham for the Bandits tried to get the ball to Hamley, taken away by Gabrielson. Long pass intercepted. Tavares. Could be a break for the Bandits.
And that pass is going for Paul Gate. Tavares just knocked it down beautifully.
Tavares plays it into the corner. Elliott will pull it in and start the offense for the Wings. McAvoy. Able to hold on to the ball despite the hit by Tavares. John McAvoy out of Villanova. Here's Chris Flynn to Kevin Finneran out of Ohio Wesleyan. In front, McAvoy tries Cowie, but Cowie standing strong. And look at the move by Tavares. That was sweet.
That was a good sign for McAvoy coming across the crease. That last shot, that exchange offensively, was very well done by Philadelphia.
Nice play by Mark Burnham, taking the ball away momentarily from Finneran, but Finneran takes it behind the back, too far for Dedekin. Bates tries to pick it up, but Kevin Alexander with a quick stick sends it long, and take down. Tavares goes down as McAvoy hits him. Play on, save the referees. McAvoy has it over to Bates. Bates moving in, going against Cordingley, who's back in action after being injured in half number one. Tavares will be called for a penalty.
Tavares came in to retaliate from the hit he received, and his, as most retaliations end up, will be spent in the box. Tavares got nailed pretty good earlier on, and he didn't forget about it. When he finally got up and came back down the field, he just picked out the first gray jersey he could find. Tavares fairly quiet tonight. One goal for the best player in the league right now. Let's take a look at Tavares' hit first. Way downfield. And the low part is what he hated about that. That is just so dangerous down around the knee areas. And that's what he didn't like about it. You can hit them all you want on a legal hit, but don't go down to the knee or below the knee area.
Something I don't even think the referees realized is that Veltman hopped onto the field before the whistle blew to complain about the call, Veltman being the captain of the team. And they could have called him for 2 penalties there, 1 for too many men on the field.
They got it for 1. Cowie making sensational saves. Push, they'll give it back to Philadelphia. Action all over the crease. Veltman going into their defense again. But how about this Cowie? Is he playing a game?
A double minor, apparently, the call, as we take another look at this.
Yeah, so Veltman's, I mean, Tavares has 3.5 minutes left.
Gary Gate flips it in, and it gets through. A lot of confusion in front of the net. Gary Gate out of Syracuse taking advantage of it.
It's been a long time. Gate has not scored in so long. Watch him come through and flip it underneath. Cowie got a piece of it, but when he hit it down, it bounced the goal. Watch Cowie get just a little hunk of this ball. No real good shot by Gary, but Gary just shuffled in there hoping something would happen with all the confusion in front of Ross Cowie, and it did. 18th goal for Gary. That's only the second Gate goal of the night.
Are you saying he shuffled it off in Buffalo?
Shuffled it off to Buffalo.
I just wanted to make sure. 7-5, it's a two-goal game.
And that penalty is over.
I see it was a double minor, so the minor would be released as opposed to a major, which would have taken two goals to be released.
A lot of offense by Philadelphia dominating on these faceoffs, and now that's paying some dividends.
And the fans here getting a little quiet.
John, that's their first back-to-back goal scoring. Finneran, and then Gary Gate.
No Scrant with a shot. It goes wide, and that ball rocketed in there so hard, it goes all the way back to Dallas Elliott. That's a 30-second violation. Those hard shots are great, but sometimes they'll cost you.
The ball doesn't go anywhere. It stays right on top of that green carpet.
Bandits wanting to get back on track.
There is a lot of hitting going on in that cylinder. Philadelphia protecting that area with great defensive players like Tony Rich.
Here's Rich Kilgore behind the net, to the back of the net.
Rich Kilgore gets his third goal of the season. Watch him roll right inside of Conley. Now when he gets Elliott positioned on the near pipe, he wraps it around behind him. Beautiful job right there again. Sets Elliott against the left pipe, wraps around his back, and gets that goal to the far pipe. Beautiful job. One more time. Kilgore inside, gets the goalie going to the far pipe, and then boom, wraps it right around behind his back.
Rich Kilgore with his third goal this year, moving a little bit more into the comfort zone, but only for a moment as Rob Sheck gets the goal for the Wings to make it 8-6, and so quickly the tide of the game can change.
Well, Philadelphia is winning this quarter 4-3, and Rob Sheck's a big part of that. He scored the first goal of the second half. He just scored the fourth goal of the second half. Two of the last four for Philadelphia. He's a force. Big Rob Sheck, All-American out of Towson State. And he does his job as he comes in there and just powers his way in. He's doing a good job now of knowing that he has to get behind Cowie. And Sheck did it on the power play goal earlier in this third quarter. This time he just dives in from the cylinder to get an advantage right or left of Cowie.
8-6. The Bandits with a lead. 4:20. Clock rolling to go. And now 8-7. That's here on top of the Wings. Rob Hoynes takes it right in there. Almost militaristic as he goes in there. Very appropriate for a man from West Point.
Well, Hoynes only had two goals in the season, but watch this. Great speed. He comes in. The defense plugs the middle. He comes in. Cowie's now looking a little bit weak. Goal number 7.
It's a one-goal game. Keenan against Gabrielson on the faceoff as we return. It's an 8-7 game as the Wings have stormed back in the third quarter.
And they've done it without the Gates. Just two goals of the 7 for the Gate brothers.
Darris Kilgore kicks it into overdrive, takes the shot, but Elliott able to grab the ball and put it into a stick. Starts the counterattack. Paul Gate behind the back. Gabrielson picks up the loose ball. This is Gary Gate. He fires that one, blocked on the outside by Veltman. Gabrielson, Sheck, Paul Gate. Gate being played very well there by Derek Keenan. Taking a look at our score, 8-7, a lot different than usual.
Well, it really is. The game, per game average is way up there in the high teens. When we talked about it at halftime with John Meridian, the general manager of Buffalo, they wanted to get a high scoring close to the 20s in offense, and they do. But tonight, with the defense being a premium, the goalies have taken over.
Gary Gage with a shot. Cowie covering up. Mahar pushes Paul Gate from behind, trying to protect Ross Cowie. The loose ball push will give the ball to the Wings with 3:09 to go. Quarter number three, Bandits 8, Wings 7.
Let's take a look at what happens right here. They're going to come in. Beautiful save. And all the activities over here, they're going to come back and just ram this guy, this referee Murray. Watch the push come in here. Paul Gate takes the referee Tim Murray back to the boards. But tremendous save by Cowie through all activity.
Cowie deflecting the Paul Gate shot. Gate enters the danger zone once again. Cowie able to get in front of it, and here come the Bandits on the counterattack.
Well, chalk that save up to Jim Beltman. He came in to double team and really take the shot away from him. Look at the hitting going on in this game.
Brian Volker with a chop, and he will be called for the penalty, much to the delight of 16,325 standing room only fans here at the Odd.
Brian Volker, there's Dave Evans looking over, trying to understand this call. Volker livid about the call. Came in, and the call, I'm sure, from Mike Ventura was that it was from behind. You saw it was very close to being from the side, but the call on Brian Volker, roughing, came in a little bit from the blind side, and that'll put Buffalo up for the first time in a while.
But as we saw in the first half, sometimes it can be an advantage for the defensive team. Here's Hamlet going in, deflected wide by Elliott. Gary Martin thought he had the loose ball. Tavares is there. Hamlet picks it up. Nice bit of hustle by Bob Hamlet.
He's up there as one of these scoring leaders.
Derek Keenan goes in, fires over the crossbar as Elliott deflects it.
Boy, he really can pull that shoulder. Elliott is amazing. Not a big guy. It looks like he's around 165 in the locker room. All those pads are deceiving, but he can go four quarters like nobody else in the Major Indoor Lacrosse League. Tremendous stamina.
Hamley, give and go, tried the redirect. It didn't go, and Darius Kilgore picks up the loose ball.
Nice play, though. They're really moving the ball beautifully and working Elliott front to back, left to right.
20 on the shot clock. Hamley to Tavares coming back in the net.
You're going to get Tavares now. Way down in here, he's going to have little or no angle. He's going to come right in behind Elliott. And that is the shot he's been looking for all night. Tavares has missed two of those earlier. He gave himself a little bit more of an angle this time and just gets it in that sliver of a target. Johnny Tavares gets goal number two when his team really needed it. Now they have a little bit of a cushion.
29th goal of the year for John Tavares out of Wolford Lawyer.
As far as tempo goes, John, again, Philadelphia really started coming on. They started ganging up the goals. Bittering and Gate got two together. Then Sheck and Hoynes got two together. Single goals for the team from Buffalo. They need to gang a few up if they want to get back on top.
On the power play.
Is that a power play goal? McAvoy at the point. Looking for the centering pass. Bittering fires it. Cowie able to pull it in. And that will be a penalty call against the Buffalo Bandits. We'll see who gets whistled for it. Looks like number six, Miles General, the 16th man.
Number six, Miles General,
referees really have had a very physical game to deal with since the opening quarter. And they've done a nice job of not letting it get out of hand, but yet letting them play the tempo that both teams have selected. And that is one intense, fast game.
Power play unit on, Finneran, the Gate brothers, Denikin and Rob Sheck. This is Sheck. Up front for Gates, who fires. Cowie is there to save it. Federer tries the sweeping motion. It won't go. Cowie on the long ball. John Tavares, one on two, and gets it to the back of the net.
the shot goes, Tavares takes off. And that's what he did here. He just takes off, gets that snowbird pass. But look at the defense by Gate. Gary Gate comes down, beats him to the cylinder. Tavares knew he didn't have much time, so he took that low shot that beat Dallas Elliott. One more time, a look at it. Tavares looks back, sees Gary Gate, and cannot beat the speed of Gary Gate. He took the only shot he had, and it was accurate enough to beat Elliott.
A penalty will be called against Jim Beltman. As Chris Flynn going for the shot, Beltman sticked him up a little high and hit Flynn in the face mask. And a timeout is called by the Philadelphia Wings.
Well, they've got a two-man situation here. There'll be two men up on Buffalo. You can see the guys, the box is getting pretty full of orange jerseys. Philadelphia's got to dent the nets here. They have to take advantage of this. Things are getting a little bit out of hand. They've got a three-goal difference now in the score.
Next week, we will be at the Joe Louis Arena in Detroit for the matchup between the New York Saints and the Detroit Turbos.
Talk about defense. Two of the best right there, and Sal Acacio in the nets for the Saints, and of course, Ted Sawicki for Detroit. We saw him set a record last time on Prime.
The way the attendances are around the league, it may be tough to get a ticket to the championship. There is one way you can get there. You can fly there. The Major Indoor Lacrosse League, fly away to the championship. Send a postcard with your name, your address, and daytime phone number to 2310 West 75th Street in Perry Village, Kansas, 66208. Get your entry in by April the 1st. And if your card is selected, you get to join us at the championship game. 16,325 very loud people at the Odd in Buffalo, and they just love their Bandits. This is fun.
I tell you it is, and if you look at the very top rung of this arena, as we can see from here, you see people standing up, standing room only. A lot of those tickets were sold for this game.
Two-man power play, a super power play for the Wings. Paul Gate can't get it by Cowie.
Tavares almost cooked him by going out and double-teaming way out. When you're that many men down, you don't want to gamble that far out. Tavares lost that gamble and put Cowie in a very bad spot.
A penalty coming up. Stewart is going to allow the clock to run out on quarter number three. And let's listen to this crowd. 16,325 fanatical Bandit fans see their team with a three-goal lead going into quarter number four. Three goals tonight by John Tavares. The Gate brothers held to two. That's been the story of this one. 10-7 as we get underway for quarter number four. And if it looks like there are not enough people out on the field, you're right.
Four on three right now. Two men in the box for the button for the Bandits, and one in the box for Philadelphia.
Paul Denikin breaking up the pass. And the Wings with the four on three advantage. Check, Gate, Gate, and Denikin out there. This is Gate losing control of the ball, and Gary Gate picks up the loose ball right in front of the net and gets it by Ross Cowie, and it's 10-8.
Gary Gate gets a second goal. Both of them are just sort of garbagey in front, but they're equally as tough. This ball's gonna bounce around in front. Nobody picks up. Look at Cowie way out here. And now when you pick it up, you spin back to an open net, wide open behind Cowie. Cowie gambled coming out, lost the gamble to the great stick of Gary Gate. Remember, Gary's other goal was that one he just shoveled in front of the cylinder. So those two goals, opportunistic goals from up front.
10-8. Illegal procedure called on the faceoff. And Buffalo with a two-goal lead, trying to prevent the Wings from the comeback. Mark Hahn working against Kevin Alexander, a four-on-four situation. Conley fires to the back of the net, and it's a one-goal game as John Conley, with a shot from the outside, past Ross Cowie.
Conley did a great job of just putting that high velocity shot. And this is the opposite side that he scored from last time. This time he goes to his left. The goalie's right. Look at Cowie protecting in the other corner, because that's where the last shot came from. But Cowie has, Conley has two goals in that same spot. One to the goalie's left corner, one to the goalie's right pipe. Conley teaches gym in Northern Maryland, in Northern Baltimore County, Bel Air.
Hand off the faceoff. The Bandits get it. Stu Aird to Veltman, back to Aird, to the back of the net.
Great job of work by Veltman. This ball's going to come down. Now watch to our right. Veltman's going to take it right here, and then he's going to feed right back over. Shot comes in and goes right into the goal. Boom. Ellen never got a chance to get settled, and credit Veltman with the great movement on that. Aird feeds him and gets it back for his second goal of the game.
Stu Aird out of Oakvale, Ontario, University of Windsor. 11-9, the Bandits with a two-goal lead. But you better believe that the Gate-led Wings are not going to give up.
Paul Gate, if you're counting on your scorecard, one goal. He had the first goal of the game when his team was two men down, has not scored since. He drew a foul right there, though. They're going to pull Veltman back into the box. Veltman was guarding Paul Gate. He gets called for wrapping him up. A darn near tackle. 29 quarters, Philadelphia, slow start. 5 in the third quarter. They really got things moving beautifully. And then, of course, Buffalo fairly even, matching them in the third.
Did we say low scoring game? I think they wanted to prove us wrong in half number two. Power play unit on for the Wings. Keenan deflects the ball from in front of the crease, and look at the hustle by Tavares. But Denikin picks it up, sends it right in front for the redirect by Finneran, hits the pipe. Darius Kilgore working against Gary Gate. Sends it back to Ross Cowie. Finneran working on the 50-50 ball against Stu Aird. And a 30-second violation will be called.
325. Finneran had a great chance with the far pipe. He just didn't collect the ball and get it in there, but that's exactly what they want to do, moving it from one pipe to the next.
Right in front for Finneran, who tries to redirect. The hands are up on the officials, which means another delayed penalty coming up, which will make a 5-on-3 situation for the Philadelphia Wings.
Well, I didn't see the penalty, but Finneran he's locked himself up behind the goal. He's not even giving himself a shot. That last time, Kevin really didn't even have it. Watch when he gets this ball. Here's Kevin back in here, and he'll get the ball behind the plane and not really have a shot. Comes back in. Now look, he comes over, ill or no angle, bounces it in front.
The Wings call timeout to set their strategy down by two. 11-9 Bandits on Prime Network. Wings on the super power play as we return to the odd, and just that quickly, Denikin makes it a one-goal game, 11-10. Paul Denikin with the goal.
Well, this is that one side to the other side that makes it look so easy. The pass will come in and go from the goalie's left to the goalie's right. Boy, it looks easy when they do it. By making the pass all the way to the backside, and of course, comes in right behind Cowie, who doesn't have anything to do. He's so far out, there's too much space behind him. Again, Denikin begging for the ball, gets it, just redirects it. Look at that. Cowie is so far out. That's what we've been talking about all day, John. He's so far out. You make one pass to the far side, and you get it. It's an easy slam dunk.
5-on-3 now becomes 5-on-4. Wings still with a power play, but the penalty killing unit that has been quite successful for the Buffalo Bandits on the field here. 1:15 to go in the penalty. This is Derek Keenan. Keenan looking in front for Veltman, plays it to the far side, Brian Hall. Two on the shot clock. Hall takes the shot. That's a reset of the clock as Aird goes after it. And masterful killing of the penalty so far by Buffalo.
Veltman in there trying to suck that one up. Ground ball master doesn't get it.
With 45 seconds to go in the penalty, Denikin has it into the attack zone. Sets up the offense. Both Gates are out there along with Rob Sheck and Kevin Finneran. This is Rob Sheck. His shot goes wide, bounces high into the stands. The Bandits will get the ball with 28 to go on the penalty.
They've been giving Sheck that hard right-handed shot from the top most of the night.
Looks for the shot, fires it wide right. Hamley trying to get his rebound, picked up by Gary Gate. It's Gary Gate and Kevin Finneran going two on two. This is Finneran looking for the trailer, but he misses Mark Hahn, and the loose ball picked up by Hall, who drops it right in front. Finneran with a loose ball, has control, gets it to Gary Gate, but Gate can't control. Veltman.
Snowbirds back, almost a little unfair, but he knows how to take advantage and just puts it past Elliott with two great fakes. Elliott tiring a little bit, and Tavares picking his spots.
12-10, Bandits, two-goal lead. And what could possibly be called a one-game highlight film. This game's been full of it.
Be a great learning tool for both teams as they look ahead to a potential matchup in the championship game. Both teams would like to get that far and repeat last year's sensational game in Philly.
15 on the shot clock as Brian Hall works it at the point. Gwen Lay behind the back tried to get it to Rich Kilgore, played off the ball very well by Hoynes. Here's Gary Martin on the counterattack as the wings can't find the advantage. Conley in front for Hoynes, who can't control it. Hoynes slips in the corner. Hall takes him down, plays him off the ball. Nice play there by Brian Hall.
Philadelphia looking for the man off the ball, making some nice passes. That time didn't connect, but the thought was much better with the ball movement later in the game than it was earlier in the game.
Derek Keenan. Stick checked away by Volker. Veltman picks it up. Keenan is there, but can't control the ball. Accordingly, will be called for the loose ball hold, and the Wings will get possession with 7:49 to go. That's in good. Regulation, 12-10, Bandits.
It's good to see Corson running well. He's got that leg bandaged up. He's run well this whole second half.
Gabrielson to Denikin. Check. Gary Gate deflected wide by Cowie. Denikin working against Veltman. And Veltman will be called for the hold. Wings will get possession back. 7:28 on the clock. New 30-second shot clock. Denikin will start the play. Sheck in front, open, and puts it into the goal.
Sheck did a sensational job of working off a pick by Scotty Gabrielson. It starts right up top, and this gets them goal number 11 back within one, but it was Sheck working off the pick. He comes across, off Gabrielson, takes the shot, and beats Cowie. Here it comes in, off this pick, comes right around, takes the shot, and beautifully done to get them within one.
Off here, Chris Flynn against Kevin Alexander, one of the best. And Alexander looks to have won the faceoff, getting it back to Stu Air.
He's such a crafty veteran. Alexander won't beat you in a foot race these days, both knees bandaged, but he can certainly do the faceoff, and he can finish the shooting like nobody in the game.
Holding the call against the Wings. Bandits get the ball right at the point. Mark Burnham to take it. Randy Marnes. Marnes flips it to Burnham. Burnham is there. His shot goes wide. Over the boards. Wings will get it with 6:57 to go in regulation, 12-11. Buffalo Bandits with a lead. Dallas Elliott, Ross Cowie, both have been in the game the entire game. And you have to think that one of them is going to get tired soon. Maybe now they're running on pure adrenaline.
Well, Elliott, I'm always amazed at the intense action he weathers in the goal, but yet he plays four quarters time and time again.
10 on the shot clock. Finneran working behind the goal. What defense by Burnham, but Finneran breaks away, tries to bounce it by Cowie. He doesn't do it. Alexander chasing after the ball, catches up to it, and almost put it in the goal. Oh, my.
Pushed from behind, though, maintained position. If anybody had a chance of shooting it, this is the guy you wanted there. He'll bring this thing down and just wrap it around his shoulder. Watch the impossible angle he's going to use with his shoulder. Wraps it right around and tries to slam dunk from almost no angle. Literally, there wasn't an angle, but he tried it nevertheless.
If at first you don't succeed, put it the back into the net. Kevin Alexander.
Alexander is the guy you don't want down around the crease. He is just too good with the stick. As he pushes in past Hahn, wants the fakes to get the movement right in here, finally comes over the top and beats Elliott. Tremendous job by this guy, the veteran Kevin Alexander, in the Hall of Fame in Canada, one of the greatest to ever play the game of lacrosse, and at 37, still one of the best finishers.
Listen to the crowd at the odd. One more look at this amazing piece of work.
Well, Kevin Alexander muscled in behind Hahn, and here's two veterans about 37 years old each. Gets by Mark Hahn, and then Elliott's one-on-one with him. The defense let Hahn down by not sliding over there and taking Alexander out. And Kevin, when he gets in that close, there he is, number 26. Kevin gets that close, he can fake the goalie like nobody else in the game. He makes the fakes so convincing. He'll make the stick, he'll go right in the goalie's face almost, so the goalie has to fight on the fake, and then he'll dump it in behind you.
The Wings win the faceoff as Rob Hoynes comes away with it. 5:50 to go here at the odd. Bandits 13, Wings 11. Flynn in front, played off the ball beautifully by Bob Hamlin, and here come the Bandits. Hamlin, Kilgore, Brian Hall slips in front. Volker plays him off the ball, and the Wings on the counterattack.
Give it up for number 26, Kevin Alexander.
Here's Denikin. Kick save, Cowie. The Bandits fans almost calming down, waiting for a new surge of energy.
This is not a good matchup defensively for Buffalo.
McAvoy tried the shot.
They got away with something there because the gate line came on. They didn't have that line. They like to match up Keenan, and they like to match up Belton against the gates. Well, they had a good matchup, but the gates sort of hurried the shot and only got one. Buffalo staved off a big one.
Derek Keenan. Looking for the left-handed shot, takes it, pulled right in by Elliott, looking for the long pass, plays it short to Paul Gate, who had Gary Gate running long.
Where's Gary Gate?
Gate looking for the shot, kick save, Kelly. Check on the rebound, still has it and puts it to the back of the net. It's 13-12 with 4:19 to go in the game.
Robbie Scheck is a rising star in the Major Indoor Lacrosse League. He is built just like the Gates. Watch him wheel inside two defenders. Now his stick is free. Nobody coming in to help, and he just gets it behind Cowie. Once he got behind, watch, one defender, two defenders. Now nobody backs up in the cylinder. Cowie has little to do, but watch that one bounce behind him. Scheck, all strength with that 6'2", 215 frame. All-American out of Towson State. They went to the national finals his senior year.
It's a one-goal game. 3:47 to go and a sold-out odd in Buffalo. The Tavares comes away with it. Waits, fires, deflected wide by Elliott. Volker goes after the ball, doesn't see Burnham there, who puts a thunderous hit on him.
These teams are still going end to end zone.
Mark Hahn trying to bull his way in there, holding the call. Wings will get the ball. We'll be right back in just a moment. 13-12 Bandits.
I'm giving them one to the girls.
When traveling, stay where the teams of the Major Indoor Lacrosse League stay. In Baltimore, the Sheraton Inner Harbor. In Boston, the 57 Park Plaza Hotel. In Buffalo, the Buffalo Hilton. In Detroit, the Omni International. In New York, the Long Island Marriott. In Philadelphia, the Philadelphia Airport Marriott. Stay at the best, the official hotels of the Major Indoor Lacrosse League.
Lacrosse is America's fastest growing and most exciting sport. And for the best in equipment, it's Allman Sports International. Sticks with exclusive Allman pockets. Custom dyed with your team colors. Helmets, gloves, and protective gear. Team jerseys, shorts, sweats, t-shirts, and other great accessories. Allman Sports International has everything you need to play your best and look great doing it. For a free catalog, call 1-800-BESTICK.
Back at the yard, 3:13 to go, 13-12, Conley trying to tie it up. That ball will go over the glass, and the Bandits will get possession.
I'll tell you, that line that Philadelphia starts with, check, gate, and gate, that line could play with anybody in this game. And then I'd love to see him play basketball. They're so big. I'd like to see him play football. They're so athletic and strong.
Down to the last 3 minutes. This is Rich Kilgore working against Kevin Finneran. Hamley at the point. Glenn Lay, the big man, powers his way in there. Gets the shot. Elliott with a save. Crease violation will be the call, and the Wings will get it.
Glenn Lay just ran over Chris Flynn. I think that's who was playing defense on him. Right there, Flynn locks up. Flynn played football at Penn, but no match for Lay. Lay just lays him out. He comes in and gets leveled himself.
Gary Gate wants to tie it up. Dedekin tries. It won't go. Finneran. Finneran in front. McAvoy can't get it by Cowie. Gary Gate trying for it, but Cowie pulls it in.
Philadelphia doing a great job, John, of moving the ball from one person to the person off the ball. The passing is really putting a lot of pressure on Cowie.
End of the final 2 minutes. Keenan looking for the insurance goal. In front, Dolphin! Can't get it by Elliott. Ball loose in the corner. Whistle blows.
I think we have a two-minute penalty on Buffalo. The streak here, 14 in a row for Buffalo, including three playoff victories, the longest winning streak in MIL history. So every win, of course, adds to that magical record. They're trying to keep it alive, but Philadelphia, who lost to them in the finals, the championship last year, they want to win this one.
Too many men on the field, the call. So with 1:52 to go in the game.
Yeah, I think that's a tough call, John. Would you agree on this time in the game?
And Gary Gay trying to make it even tougher on him. Shep tries it by Cowie. That is about as tough as you can get. A bench penalty in the final 2 minutes of the game. Now the officials talking about who touched it last.
All right, Tom Young came over and got Mike Ventura squared away. He saw, look at Shep wrapping around. He's learned from the Gates how to use that feed and shoot around his shoulder. He's got a great left hand and right hand, but he wraps it around to try to get the goalie off the bounce.
Ross Cowie brings it out to set up the offense. The Wings with an extra man, and he will dump it into the corner. Into the final 90 seconds. It's a one-goal game.
Five
and the Wings with the power play opportunity. This is Kevin Finneran for the charging shot. That shot hits the pipe and comes out.
Shep is really doing a beautiful job. He's shooting from the outside and then finding the cylinder when they give it to him.
Rob Shep tries it again. Can't get it by Cowie. Dedekin tries to sweep it in. Ball is loose right in front. And Ross Cowie
was smart enough to come out of the goal, but he knew his team was down one man. He gave himself some time.
Holding the call, the Wings will get it. 45 seconds to go. Watch out for the Gate brothers here. This is Paul Gate at the point. Fans to their feet at the arm. Shot. Gate tries it. Rob Sheck. Pulled in by Dennis Kilgore. Loose ball picked up. This is Dedekin. 17 to go. Intercepted by Dennis Kilgore. And time will run out on the Wings. Tonight's game brought to you in part by the Buffalo Hilton, the official headquarters hotel of the Major Indoor Lacrosse League in Buffalo. The Coors Light player of the game, John Tavares. What a night he had.
Well, he got the second goal of the game, but then he scored three of the last five to give him four for the night. This guy, the best in the league right now, and he proved it tonight. Here's a shot he made late in the game, the snowbird to him, and watch him go one-on-one, the big fakes to beat Elliott, who was tough in the nets but just couldn't save that one. Tavares led his team to victory.
And the fans went nuts. Needless to say, the players did too, saying thank you, Buffalo, for a job well done in the stands and a job well done on the field. The Bandits, 13-12 over Philadelphia. We will be back to wrap it up from the yard in a minute. Tonight's Major Indoor Lacrosse League Game of the Week is brought to you by Coors Light. It's the right beer now. By Adidas, the official footwear supplier of Major Indoor Lacrosse. And by Rhyme, the power behind the game. Our final score from the odd in Buffalo, 13-12, the Bandits' winning streak continues. Next week on Prime Network, we will be at the Joe Louis Arena in Detroit for the matchup between the New York Saints and the Detroit Turbos. For Lee Felsmo, I'm John Horton. And 16,325 of our closest friends saying good night from Buffalo.